My name is Sergeant Clint Reynolds, U.S. Marines, Marine Corps martial arts instructor.
And we're here to get you fit for duty!
A show by the military, for the military, and for anyone else who wants a hardcore workout prepared to sweat.
Hoorah! Thanks for tuning in for Fit for Duty. Motivated Infantry Sergeant here is going to teach you today combat conditioning and some self-defense moves. Go along with the moves that myself and Captain Andreas has taught you in the past. So let's kick it off. Today we're going to do some upper body strikes, all right? They're going to consist of inside, outside freaking strikes, some chin jabs, and some elbows. Throw them in there. Remember, all these moves will be used for combat condition or self-defense only. So don't hurt yourself and don't Jackie Chan anybody in the supermarket. You guys ready to kick it? You guys ready to go? All right, as always, like we told you in the past, everything starts off in the basic warrior stance. Just ready to kick it off and freaking fight. All right, first move we're going to teach you is the outside, all right? In the Marine Corps, we call it the knife hand, all right? What it is basically your hand looks like a knife. Pretty creative title, right? All right, your striking distance is going to be from the part of your finger all the way down to your palm. Not the tips of your fingers. You don't want to, you know, break any digits, all right? Basically, the strike, what it looks like, come here, is if you're with an opponent, you find yourself close combat-wise, the area of target is the neck, all right? You're going to come in, you're going to strike him on the side, you know, deflect his hand if you need to. That's a knife hand. This is going to be the freaking outside, all right? Simple move, really good, but effective. The neck has an arteries, you know, freaking a lot of good stuff. Really bad point if you get hit. So let's do this, and if you do it safely and slowly at first, all right? Everybody start with the basic warrior stance. All right, you can either have your hands extended, or if you want, close your fingers. As long as you make sure to, you know, not do the hammer fist, do the knife hand fist, you're going to hit with the palm of your finger, right? You're going to come in, you're going to strike, go right back to the basic warrior stance. So it'll look like this. Strike. 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 That's it. Simple, right? All right, we'll see. You guys ready to kick it? All right, we're going to go do it. Doing some air, doing some slow first, and then we'll speed up later on in the show, do bag drills. All right, everybody, get ready. Strike. 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 Now remember, keep going it. Remember when you do these moves, you want to flare the heel, all right? You want to add your counterweight. That way you're getting the full force of it. If you just throw your arm out, you're going to hit the person. It's not going to really affect it. If you throw your body into it, you're going to really jack them up. So make sure you get motivated, throw your body into it. All right, strike. 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 All right. You guys look like you got it. You guys are pros right here. All right. That's outside. All right. For the inside, all it is once you come in, say you miss the person or you hit them, and you want to add an extra little blunt force, you come back, you throw your hand up, and you come back down, and you hit the other side of their neck or whatever target area you know, basically can hit. All right. Everybody good to go? All right. So it's going to look like this. Simple. All right. Kick ass. All right. Let's kick it. All right. Ready? Strike. 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 Keep doing it. Now remember, just like the motivated freaking army bubble right here is doing, he's throwing it out, flaring the heel. Now see, like motivated Corporal Barnes here, this Jackie Chan stuff, not like that, all right? You want to make sure you're using your body, all right? Not just your arms. You get a lot more force if you use your body and not just your arm muscles, all right? Do it again. Sort of better. He's just got those Gumby arms going. All right, you guys ready? All right, you guys comfortable? All right, those are your freaking knife hand strikes. The next one is chin jab, all right? This is a really, really good move. It's really effective, all right? Come at me. This is one of the favorite moves because there's a lot of continuance moves if we do shows in the future to help teach you, all right? Basically, what you can do is when the person comes in, you're going to take the striking palm, you know, striking part of your palm, you're going to basically plant it up into his freaking face, all right? Your target area is the chin, the nose, all right? This can cause a lot of damage. You hit somebody in the nose, they're going to tear up, they're going to be hating life. You know, if you hit it really, really hard, it can cause some major damage or serious damage. So once again, if you practice these moves, make sure to do it slowly and don't actually strike the person. I don't want anybody getting hurt. All right, you guys ready? All right, once again, you're going to start from the basic stance, all right? The basic move is going to look like this. Make sure to flare the heel, and you're using that palm strike force right here, all right? Once you don't lock out your arm totally, you want to really use your arm force because this is going to freaking push it up in there and really damage them. You guys ready to kick it off a little? Everybody, ready? Strike. Strike. Keep doing it. All right. just like all of them are doing, make sure you keep your hand. You want to freaking close palm it, push it up into it. Hey, bro. Strike. Do a couple more. All right, take it easy. All right, everybody comfortable with that one? All right, we just showed you the chin jab strike, all right? Another knife hand that we have, all right, it's the vertical one. Basically, what you're going to do, this is the stuff you see in the movies, I'm chopping wood, blocks, all the kind of high-speed, you know, cool karate sort of stuff, all right? You're coming from high, coming down, all right? Striking service, be like if you ended up punching the person, oh, they're in pain, all right? Striking surface is the neck. You're going to come down using the knife hand right down on their neck, really cause some damage, really take a person out. Once again, you're using the meaty portion of your palm up into the part of your digits, all right? You don't want to hit your, you know, you don't want to freaking do the wrist. You don't want to do your fingers. You don't want to break anything, all right? You guys ready to kick it? All right. Basically, for this, you're going to come down. You're going to flare the heel a little bit, but your power is dropping your weight. That's where you get the striking power, right? Make sure to always keep your hands up, like I said, in the basic warrior stance. Once you're done with the move, you're going to come right back up. So all it's going to be is just like that. Once again, the more you drop your weight, you add your weight into it, the more power you're going to get with your strike. Good to go? Kill. You guys ready to kick it? All right, ready? Strike. Go. Keep going. All right, Corporal Perry, he's deciding to use the full knife hand, which is fine. Rest of them. And I have to correct myself, not an Army Bubba, an airman. That's my bad. All you guys can whoop my butt later on. Just like that. Really, really good using your body. You guys comfortable? You guys good? All right. Next one, last couple, there's elbow strikes. All right. You got the rear elbow strike. Say I'm fighting this guy, and then suddenly his buddy likes to decide to come up behind, try to pull one of those sucker punch moves you always see in the bar fights and all that kind of crap. Basically, what you're going to do is once you've taken out this enemy, you're going to look in the rear, you're going to come back, you're going to strike the enemy, and go back to your main opponent, all right? Rear elbow strike, pretty self-explanatory. So it's going to look like this. Step right back into it, all right? You want to use your weight. You want to basically want to keep your arm vertical. Use the cutting part of your elbow. Really strike them. Aim for the face, whatever you can, to hit them. Just like this. Simple, right? All right, we'll see. You guys ready to kick it? All right, basic warrior stance. Ready? Strike. Now remember, you're not just going to throw your elbow back unless you're high speed and you got, you know, eyes in the back of your head. You're going to check your opponent, make sure acquire whatever you're going to hit. You're going to step back, you're going to strike, and go right back. All right? Doesn't make any sense if you're doing this. Trust me, we see it. I don't want to see it, you. All right. So everybody, make sure you acquire your opponent and then strike it. Ready? Strike. Do a couple more. All right. Copa Perez doing a good job. He's going all the way back, using his body weight. Hey, bro. You guys good? I can feel the motivation today. That's all right. We'll pay for it later. All right? The last and final elbow strike you have is basically high to low. All right? Say you don't want to give a knife hand. You really want to cause them some pain. All right? You're going to drop your elbow. You know, this could be really good. Freaking using the freaking neck or the back. All right? This is a basic strike right here. You're going to come down. Say you don't want to do this. You're just going to throw it down. Once again, same principles as doing the freaking vertical knife hand. You're going to drop the weight. Really, really do the cutting edge of your elbow. If you're like me, you got some really good elbows. Cause some damage. You guys ready to kick it? All right. Everybody, basic warrior stance. Ready? Exercise. Strike. All right. Barnes is doing a good job. He's looking at his target. He's hitting it. He's coming right back to the basic warrior stance. All these guys are doing a good job of keeping their freaking self, you know, the self-defense. You don't want to drop your hands. That way you don't get hit upside the head or anything crazy. You guys good? All right. Relax. Hey, we're going to take a short break. When we come back, we're going to do the bag drills, get all this stuff, get your heart rate working, you know, see what you've learned. See you in a little bit. On three decks. Hey, thanks for coming back. All right, the first half of the show, we took it easy on you. Taught you all the basic moves, all the vertical knife hand stuff, elbow, and then chin jab. This next part of the show is we're going to hit the bags, really start working it and getting sweating. You guys ready? You guys ready? All right, let's kick it off. We're going to start out with 15 side straddle hops. Just get the blood flowing, then we'll pick up the mats, start really whacking at it. Good to go? Good to go? You guys are motivated as hoo-ha today. All right, you guys ready? Exercise. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. This is what you asked. Get a little louder. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 5 more to go. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. You guys good? All right, relax, relax. All right, pick up the bag. All right. These two are going to demonstrate if you have a buddy, if you can get a bag. They're going to demonstrate what you can do. Motivated Colton Perry, he's going to be the shadow boxer, all right? Once again, you guys can do this at home, get in front of a mirror. You'll get a really good workout. You might not get the real contact to hit in the back, but you still get the heart rate going, still get a good freaking sweat going. All right, you guys ready? All right, basically what we're going to do, we're going to start off with your knife hand strikes, I told you. Remember, we got the outside, the inside, and the vertical. We're going to do some outside knife hand first. All right, if you're holding the bag, if you have a bag, if you have a partner, battle buddy, whatever you guys call it in your service, just turn a little bit. That way, when he strikes, basically he's going to hit it, not hit the face or anything. You want to make sure you have eyes on the opponent. That way, you don't hit him in the face. If you're shadow boxing, basically it's going to be the same thing that we did before. Just add in a little extra oomph. Don't overextend yourself. Don't overextend your ligaments or anything. We don't want to cause any pain. You guys ready to kick it? All right. Ready? Strike. 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 Keep going. All right. Now, just like this, remember, basically what your target is, you're going to be in the neck. Just like how he's going, he's keeping his freaking hand up, protecting his face. He's got his hands curled. He's not doing the hammer fist. He's doing the knife hand. That's why we call it the knife hand. All right. Five more. 4, 3, 2, 1. All right. Switch off. You can demonstrate left-handed. All right, see? Adapt and overcome. You guys ready to kick it? All right, ready? Strike. 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 Keep going. All right, now, in the military, what do we teach you? The more you sweat in peacetime, the less you bleed more. So really get into it. You know, you want it just like it is. The opponent's feeling it. At the same time, you don't want to cause yourself too much pain, all right? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right. You guys ready? Cool? Cool? All right. That was the outside. Next one is going to be the inside. All right. Basically, what you're going to do, just for demonstration purposes, you're going to act like you missed your target. You're going to come back in for the actual blow. It helps if your opponent basically alternate. Obviously, he knows that you're going to try to hit him on this side. So if he wants to turn his body, so you graze it. And then once you come in for the actual strike, you can turn it. That way you can really actually hit it. You're not hitting the side or hitting them upside the head or in the ear or someplace crazy. All righty, good to go. You guys ready? All right. Exercise. Strike. 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 Keep going. He's using all the fundamentals that we taught you before. Keeping his freaking guard up. Just throwing out the heel. Adding in the body. Perry's doing it. Left-handed. For all you left-handers people out there. Motivator right here. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, put the bags down. 10 side straddle hops. Ready? Make it quick. Exercise. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, man, they can't keep up. All right. 1, 2, 3, 10. Anybody? No push-ups? All right. Pick up the bag. Next one, it's going to be the vertical, all right? This is the one where if you hit your opponent, oh, no, he's falling over, leaves his neck open, you're going to hit it and strike it. Just like he's doing, take a knee, use a little target. Most pads have a little target. See that nice target? Hit that right there. Don't hit him in the face. Don't hit it down here. You don't want to cause the bag to flip up or anything. Once again, your shadow, same thing, just what we were doing before. Just add in a little extra oomph for it. You guys ready? Exercise. Strike. 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 Keep going. All right? Motivated Airmen, that's right, Air Force, is whooping it, doing a perfect example of it. He's clearing the hill, he's dropping his body. If you could tell, if this was your neck, you'd be in a lot of pain. All right? What's that teach you? Air Force can hit just as hard as the Marine Corps. They rock. You like that plug? All right. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right. All right. Very well. Get up. All right. Next one, chin jab strike, right? This is one of my favorite ones. This is one where you really get the power. You can really jack somebody up, right? Basically, you're going to hold the bag. You're going to hold it a little higher than you normally would. Just like how he is, he's taking his head away because he knows the bag's going to come up, right? You're going to take your basic warrior stance. You're going to pick a target. Act like that's the dude's face, whoever you really hate in life, boss, co-worker, I don't know. Not that I'm saying you want to hate people. All right, anyway. You're going to strike just like this. All right? You want to make sure to use the striking palm of your freaking hand, all right? Flare out the heel and just go right back. Basic warrior stance. Getting ready to whoop it on. You guys good? All right, you can give the bag to him. He needs to get some pain going. We'll work you in a second. All right, ready? Exercise. Strike. 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 Keep going. All right, you can see he's extending his elbow, but not all the way out, all right? If you extend your elbow too much, you hyperextend it, all right? Really, really bad. If some of you play tennis, you might have done it. It really hurts you. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, put the bags down. All right, this time we're going to do mountain climbers. Throw it up a little bit. Ready? We're going to do 15. Exercise. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 5 more. 1, 2, 3. Speed it up. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. All right. Get up. Stretch it out. All right. The next one, elbow strikes. All right. Pick up the bag. First elbow strike we taught you, it's a rear elbow strike. You just jacked up the guy that's in front of you. Suddenly you see one of his little homies, whatever, come up from behind. You're going to acquire the target. You're going to strike it and go right back. So say this is the dude wants to jack me up from behind. Sucker move. I hate it. All right. Do whatever you're doing up front. Acquire the target. Come back. That's it. All right. Hopefully your first really good move knocks him out in a perfect world. It will. If not, then adapt and overcome. All right. You guys ready? All right. Ready? Exercise. Strike. 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 Keep going. All right, like I said, you can see it's not a real, real powerful move. You can still really, really hurt somebody up. I know he's working it because he's got sweat pouring off his face. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, relax. All right, your next one, high to low, right? This is the one in case you don't want to do the knife hand. You want to drop the cutting elbow. You're going to come down. You're going to strike. Go right back, right? Basically, aim for the neck, the back, wherever the case may be. You guys ready? They're fighting over who gets to punch who. All right, ready? Exercise. Strike. Keep going. All right. Perry's doing a good job. He's showing. He's dropping all his weight. Like he said, you might not have the bag. You might not be able to get a real, real good work on, but you can still get a good fundamental of it. Condition your arms and do all that stuff. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, relax. All right, let's finish it off. Set of 15, really, really quick. Ready? Exercise. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Slow it a little down. 1, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. All right, relax. You guys good? All right, today we showed you a little bit more combat conditioning, self-defense, all right? We went over outside, inside, vertical, showed you a chin jab. We also showed you rear elbow and elbow high to low. Hope you guys are good to go. We're going to take a short break. When we come back, Commander Keblish, he's going to teach you train smart, staying strong, all that motivated stuff. Why catch my breath? See you in a little bit. Woo!
Hello, I'm Commander Dave Keblish, orthopedic surgeon at the U.S. Naval Academy, and here with me today is Petty Officer Joe Miller, an orthopedic tech. We'd like today to share with you some of our thoughts about core strengthening. Core strength means the development of strong abs and back muscles in order to stabilize the pelvis and lower trunk of the body for maximum delivery of power. There's a lot more to core strengthening than playing with large, loosely inflated rubber balls like this. This is called a muscle ball or a Swiss exercise ball. There's also more to core strengthening than just doing abdominal crunches, although both of these are frequently mentioned and utilized to help strengthen the core. This is called a pelvic tilt. While lying supine with your hips flexed and the weight largely on your shoulder blades and contracting your muscles the whole time, slowly tilt the pelvis forward, then backward, contracting your stomach and back muscles the whole while through both flexion and extension cycles. Perform this powerfully, slowly, and with long holds. Try several reps. Another good exercise to help strengthen the core is called quadrupeds. Starting from a position on your hands and knees while simultaneously contracting your abdominals and back muscles, slowly alternate extending first your arms and then your legs. Imagine trying to balance a coffee cup on the small of your back while doing this the whole time. Perform these motions slowly and smoothly with long holds. Once you've tried each arm and leg separately, consider trying the right leg and the left arm, or the left arm and the right leg simultaneously. Another exercise is called planking. Start prone on your elbows and your toes. Try keeping your back ultra straight. Remember, you're contracting your stomach muscles the whole time. Again, picture trying to balance a cup of tea or coffee on the small of your back. You can do this prone on your elbows and toes, or on your heels and elbows as well. Get that pelvis straight. Raise it to the sky. Hold it. Feel the burn. We can try this on the side as well, in a lateral position. On one elbow, on the sides of your foot, get that body nice and straight. Try to hold that. This is not easy. Remember, for all of these exercises, try to keep your abs and back muscles held taut throughout. Together, let's get hardcore on core strengthening. And remember, let's train smart and stay strong.
Hey, welcome back, folks. We hope you've enjoyed the last few series on combat conditioning and self-defense techniques here on Fit for Duty.
If you're lucky, maybe we'll come back and teach you more down the road.
With that in mind, stay focused and stay motivated as we get you Fit for Duty!